3, 2, 1.
Rebels!
As a young boy growing up in Chicago, Jim Christensen excelled in school and sports. But when he got to be a teenager, his life changed. His mother, who had been abused when she was a teenager, took her anger out on him.
I was never good enough. None of us were. She'd always compare us to others, and I'll never amount to anything, I was told. I'm no good.
The constant criticism took its toll.
One day, I'm building a model, and I started to sniff the glue that I used to build.
Jim started drinking and doing drugs. He was kicked out of school and joined the Army at 17. 2 years in, he was busted for drunk possession and dishonorably discharged. Back in civilian clothes, Jim met and eventually married Martha.
He was funny. He was outgoing. He was witty. He was everything that I wasn't.
Martha knew Jim used drugs occasionally, but she didn't know he was snorting coke every day.
My nose would start to bleed. Because of that, I wound up getting introduced to crack cocaine.
A heavy crack binge brought on a heart attack. A doctor told Jim if he smoked crack even one more time, he could die.
I realized this thing is taken. It's taken everything that I love from me. It was my number one priority. Not my children, not my wife, not my job.
Jim cleaned up his act for about a month.
And then one day, somebody put it in front of me, and as insane as it may sound, I did it. And I sat back, scared to death, waiting for my heart to burst.
Jim kept using crack, and after 20 years in the pizza business, he lost his job. With no income, he took money from his wife to buy drugs.
At this point in time, I wanted so much to hate him, but I didn't. I still loved him.
Eventually, his family convinced him to go to a Salvation Army rehab center. His wife and daughter dropped him off, but he didn't want to keep his end of the bargain.
My daughter and my wife were yelling from the car, you know, to go in.
And he just kept walking down the street. He was like a cold stone, just walking down the street and like he didn't even know us. And finally I said to her, honey, we just gotta let him go. He's gotta do what he's gotta do. And all we can do is pray that God will keep him safe. And if he doesn't, it's not our fault.
And I walked, found a tavern, and they drove off. I had spent my last couple dollars, got a couple of beers, and I says, well, okay, I'm ready. And that's when I walked down back to the rehabilitation center, and the guy at the desk says, you can't come in here. And I says, why? He says, you smell like alcohol. He says, I got 150 guys in here trying to get sober. I can't let you in. Well, it was in the middle of winter. It was last week of February, and it was cold. And I walked the streets all night long. I hadn't eaten for about 3 days. I was starting to come down from the drugs. So now I'm cold and I'm hungry and penniless.
Jim felt completely abandoned, but God was with him.
There was someone walking with me. And I, like I said, you know, it was an angel, but they kept me safe. I was walking some pretty harsh streets. I was like, Jim, take a look. This is your life, you know, and I didn't like it.
Jim sobered up and was allowed to check into the rehab center. There, he had another encounter with God.
I was at the lowest point of my life, and there was a Bible sitting there on the bunk. I picked it up, and at that moment, I was spoken to. And I remember real clear, the words spoken to me was, Jim, if you serve me, I will renew your life. And I'm like, wow. At that moment, I realized that I was just given a promise. At that moment, I was just filled with this hope. The shame, the guilt, it just left me. And I just knew, that everything was gonna be okay.
Jim gave his life to Christ. He was immediately delivered from his crack addiction. But Martha couldn't believe he had changed, so she wouldn't take him back. Jim moved in with his sister and volunteered at her church.
I made a profession of faith at the Easter sunrise service. This day I wanted to make a profession of faith, you know, amongst other believers.
Meanwhile, Martha and their five children had been forced to move into a one-bedroom apartment after the bank foreclosed on their home.
When the two youngest wanted to go out and see him, I felt like they betrayed me. Because I was a good parent. They were out there for almost a week, and they came back and they were so excited. And I couldn't believe that they were so excited from seeing their dad after everything he put us through. And they were saying how, Dad listens to Christian music. Dad goes to church. Dad doesn't swear anymore.
Jim moved back in with his family. In time, Martha forgave him.
When he would drive me to work, we started to pray together. And I think that's what brought us closer.
Jim's former boss gave him another shot in the pizza business. He started back as a busboy, worked his way up to manager, and eventually bought the shop he managed.
It's my dream come true. I've always wanted a pizza place of my own.
Today, the business is thriving, and three of his children work at the shop with him. He's also back in uniform.
Last year, Easter Sunday, I was enrolled as a soldier in the Salvation Army. And in order to do that, to wear the uniform, you can't drink, you can't smoke, or do drugs. To wear that uniform today, for me, is a sign of victory that God has given in my life.
Jesus said that he's the light, and he is the light that'll get you out of your darkness.
It's a miracle what he has done. He saved my life. We have to give up lordship of our own life and let Jesus be Lord and trust him. And he'll show you what he'll do. And it's amazing.